Yeah. And even the body language, you know. She is holding something to her. If she would turn this hand. I mean, she likes that Shakira is singing and everything she does. She's a champion. So that's where this smile comes from. But even the body language says, I'm holding this, what you're saying to me. I like the situation. I'm gonna hold this situation to me. And right after this, they even hug. J-Lo is hugging Shakira right after this. I mean, actually, by the body language, you should be able to see that they're not in fight mode. Yeah, like, I mean, imagine you have a little community and they have to stick to each other, because in ancient times, if there was a lion, you know, walking around your city, well, it's not a city and the lion won't walk around your city, but, you know, there are threats by nature, not enough food, not enough water, you know, you might have chosen a kind of wrong place to stay. Mosquitoes bite you, you get ill, stuff like that. So you need to be sure that even the least of this community will stick to you if needed. And if needed is, it is needed. We are a small community. We gotta survive. We can only do so if at all times, like if someone gets water, then he gets water for everyone. If someone finds some food source, he's telling everyone, stuff like that. So, because of that, people, by their biology, they will always stick to each other, because the biology, them being close to each other, spending a lot of time at the same, you know, place, will make them be more respectful towards each other. Not loving, not caring for real. With feelings, but actually just not fighting against each other. It's a fact. Sometimes in communities nowadays, people, they make these meetings. So having a meeting, you sometimes isn't even about the meeting itself. It's about spending time with each other. So you grow a close group that will stick together and work better with each other, not fight each other at least. And I'm sure this is a fact, because I've once been living at a homeless facility that wasn't really guarded, because it was a kind of a private initiative by one pastor and another one, and then two, like a Swiss guy handing out food, and then another foreign guy that was around, you know, taking care of people, like if they had some problem with this or that. So 2 times a week we had to sit with each other in a room, and once it was for a mass, and the other time was called, you know, meeting, but there wasn't really something we, you know, solved at these meetings. It was to calm down the different energies that otherwise would have fought against each other. Because there were people consuming hard drugs like heroin and cocaine. There were people that were just smokers of grass and hash. And there were people that weren't doing any of these. There were old ladies living there. Even an African woman. 2 Swiss women. Old ladies, you know, that needed help when they got their food. So you would carry their baskets up to their rooms. Or flats. Get it? Because of that, it was so calm living there. It was, everyone was kind of helping out each other. Not loving each other, you know? It's not, oh, I liked these ladies. I liked that drug user with all the pimples in his face. Using the washing machine every day. He had his way about things, so he was using the washing machine all the time. Then also, you know, the talking, like the people, they were, yes, let's go to the city, let's buy this and that. You know, at the long street where the drugs are sold, they would talk about it forever and ages. And it was just that each one was trying to find out whether the other one had some money to actually do so. So when both of them kind of sensed that the other one wanted the other one to pay for it. They kind of, yeah, let's do it some other time, or, you know, they just kind of didn't continue talking, but kind of also weren't going there. So it was kind of, you know, drug users, they have no money. So actually, they always kind of tend to look up for drugs and then would really love it to have someone else pay for their kicks. So when you watch and witness these kind of conversations, oh God, at other places I would have said to the leaders, just kick them out. But because I was there with them twice a week, I knew, well, they won't be stealing my stuff. I just knew they won't break in my flat and steal my stuff because of the whole thing, how it was organized. One of them was even secretly in love with me. He was once a medical pilot of helicopters, fell for drugs and had a relative dying, so he was owning a flat. He had no need to live there with us, other than, you know, he had no friends, and yeah, and then he was kind of waiting for me to say, yes, let's go and live in that expensive house that you got from your relative. Yeah, well, I wasn't, but you know, that one was the vibe about this place, because we had these so-called meetings. It was twice a week for maybe half an hour. 35 minutes, that one was enough. So yeah, meetings often just create a bond, and you cannot sit within these meetings and say, I hate those people, I don't want to be here, I'm never ever gonna like these people, it's disgusting what they say, I don't like what they do. Your biology will just override all these inner talking that you have, because I was thinking like this. But after living there for a summer and another kind of, you know, half a year, it was maybe at another house we had to move because the house was torn back down. Yeah, I was kind of you know, not thinking like that anymore, so it was okay for me to take part in these Sunday masses and the meetings. It was okay. Ed Kirini is the one that knows about the candidate oath form, why that even presidents can become presidents without showing a ID and having different names. Like, he's naming the names like Clinton. I once knew what Clinton's real name was. You know, so they take part in this elite's kind of media games that they play with us. As long as people are within the media, we think they are relevant and we won't fight them. So all the politicians within media are there because of that, and all the meetings they have and all the, you know, the talks and stuff that are portrayed within the media, that's for kind of, you know, us having them in our homes, in the television. And by that, our biology tricks us into thinking they are